Hi guys, I'm Dwani and this is my first YouTube video and this is just my everyday glam, a little bit outgoing makeup look. At least something quarantine brought out in me is this, and I don't know what is gonna happen. I don't know how I did it, but I just did it. Like, yeah, and if you like, please share this video and show some love. So let's just get started into this no makeup, makeup glam look. I've already moisturized my face and then starting with SPF. SPF is really important for your skin and I never skip a day without using SPF. Then for my brows, I use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow Pomade in the shade Ash Brown. And just filling my brows as normal, nothing too special. I'm just doing short hair-like strokes. For the front of my brows, I create vertical strokes. And with a spoolie, just combing through my brows. Then I am using my favorite MAC Studio Fix Concealer in the shade NC42. And this concealer is the best concealer ever. As the name suggests, this is a 24-hour concealer and this will not budge through your entire day. However tired, sweaty day you have, this will not go anywhere. So I love it as a base for my rest of the makeup. Blending is really, really important and I am just blending it seamlessly. You can take as much as time you want and blend it perfectly. Then to brighten up my face a little bit, I am using the Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer in the shade Medium. It is not very brightening because I am going for a very soft glam look. And again, I'm going to take my beauty blender and blend it. And you can take all your time again and blend it really well, because blending is really important to give a very natural effect to your makeup. Once it is blended nicely, then I move on to powder. And for powder, I'm using my Maybelline Fit Me powder in the shade 15. I bake with this powder and doesn't matter if I'm doing a natural look, a glam look, or even my usual everyday look, I only use this powder. This is the best powder you will find in the drugstore. I highly recommend this powder. And as you can see, I take my sweet time to set my face entirely because I know I don't want to retouch during my entire day. Then using a fluffy brush, I just dust off the excess powder. Then I'm using my favorite MAC Studio Fix powder in the shade NC40, and this will give the best airbrush look you can ever ask for. Again, just place the powder underneath my eyes and then take a fluffy brush to just remove any excess. Using the Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. This is going to add the slightest bit of color on the face, and I'm specifically using this bronzer because it is not very dark and so it will also give a very natural look. I'm going to use upward swiping motion, and to keep in mind, this is not a very pigmented bronzer, so you can use a little heavier hand while using this. Also, I am going to bronze up my temples and a little bit on my nose. Then to contour, I'm using my Hoola Bronzer by Benefit. And to contour my face, I'm using a fluffy tapered brush. And my sole purpose for using a fluffy and a tapered brush is that the fluffy side of the brush is going to distribute the bronzer or the contour evenly throughout my cheek. And the tapered side is going to make sure that I still have that little contour effect. I like to pat and place the bronzer exactly under my cheekbones. And then again using upward swiping motion to blend the bronzer, and whatever is remaining on the brush I will just use to softly contour my nose. And here I'm just trying to act cute for no reason. And then for the star of our makeup, the highlighter, I'm using my Strobe Genius palette and the NYX number 8 brush to highlight my cheekbones. And as everyone can see, I just don't stop while highlighting. Like, there is no end to the amount of highlighter I use. I'm definitely thinking about the amount of haters I'm gonna blind by this highlighter. And as they say, is it even a highlight if you can't see it from the galaxy? This is a very great highlight because you can use it for a natural effect and also amp it up if you want that glam look. Then using a flat eyeshadow brush, I'm going to use the same highlighter to highlight my nose, my brow bones and my inner corner. This brush works really well for the nose highlight. Highlighting your inner corner can give a very snatched effect to your entire face and it looks really nice. I also like to highlight my Cupid's bow, but you can skip it if you don't want it. Then using my favorite blush from MAC, which is Melba, which is a very muted pink blush. You can definitely go for a darker blush or a peach blush, whatever you like, but I like a more nude blush on for an everyday look, so that is why I love using this blush, which is not very overpowering. You can definitely use a heavy hand to give it a more pigmented effect. I also like to use my blush on my nose and on my temples. This will tie the entire look together. Once the skin is done, you can definitely use whichever eyeshadow you like. You can also use the same Hoola bronzer on your eyelids or just leave it bare, whichever suits you. But I'm going to use the new nude eyeshadow palette by Huda Beauty. Taking the shade Teddy, I'm going to use a very basic eyeshadow blending brush and swipe it through my lids and blending it till you get the desired effect. Then I'm gonna take a smaller pencil brush and using the shade Raw, I'm gonna run it through my lower lash line. Doing your lower lash line is really important because it enhances the shape of your eyes. I like to drag my eyeshadow a little bit out, creating a soft wing-like look. Now taking my NYX eyeliner in the shade Burnt Sienna, I'm going to draw a very small wing on my eyes. This will make your eyes look elongated and enhance the almond shape of my eyes. You can definitely skip the eyeliner part and just go with the eyeshadow, but I am doing this maroon eyeliner today because I'm going to wear something pink and maroon, so I just wanted my eyes to tie with the entire look. Also running the same eyeliner through my waterline. For mascara, I'm going to use a combination that is going to blow your mind. It is the NYX Worth the Hype mascara and the Maybelline Total Temptation mascara. I use this combination of mascara since almost 2 years now and I just can't stop using it. And if you are like me and you don't like wearing false lashes, I think this mascara is going to be your go-to. Has almost become a part of my everyday routine, but don't you worry, we can fix it later. We just want it to dry and then we can just flake it off with a spoolie. I'm running the same shade Teddy on my eyelids. The whole look together, I'm going to use this PAC Micro Finish Makeup Fixer. This is the best setting spray you will find because it not only just fixes your entire makeup, also hydrates your skin and locks your makeup in for the entire day. Even the mister deposits small particles which prevents watermarks on your face. Also make sure you take your beauty blender and pat it on your face, which gives an airbrushed look. For some people it is definitely a lot of makeup for an everyday look, but I guarantee you this will make your face feel very light even at the end of the day. For the last and final part, I'm using my NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in the shade London, which is a perfect everyday brown nude. The formula is very lightweight and it won't dry your lips even after hours of wear. I generally like to line my lips after I am done with my lipstick. This also cleans the lipstick and defines the shape of my lips. I'm using the shade Strip Down by MAC to line my lips. I do a little bit of overlining to give my lips a more fuller look. You can definitely stop here, but I wanted my lips to look a little more pink, and therefore I'm taking my Velvet Teddy lipstick by MAC, as I wanted to look a soft pink makeup look. You can definitely choose whichever lipstick you like, or depending on your dress or your day. Trust me, I have spent my entire day with this look, and at the end of the day I still look the same. You just need to find the right products that suit your skin the best. This is the end of the makeup look, and this works out for me, and I am very sure it will work out for you too. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and let me know which videos you want to see next. Thank you.